Hey there, Mustangs. Welcome to school for the week of October 8th.
Let's start off the week with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? Begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands,
one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Job well done. Let's see what's happening at Westlake this week.
For the update, let's now go to Mr. Howe for an important announcement.
Hey there, Mustangs. It is my privilege to get to share with you one of the most significant announcements in Westlake's rich history. Just last week, we received a letter from the State Office of Education giving Westlake some pretty significant good news. Now, you may not be aware of this, but in 2015, Westlake was actually identified as a turnaround school, a school needing to demonstrate some improvement, received a D letter grade on the state assessment system. But this letter that I received last week tells a little bit of a different story, and I'd like to read it. The letter is actually addressed to our superintendent, which is Dr. Martin Bates, and it says, "Dear Superintendent Bates, the purpose of this letter is to inform and congratulate Westlake Junior High School in Granite District for achieving the exit criteria for Cohort 1 under the School Turnaround and Leadership Development Act. When Westlake Junior High School was identified as a Cohort 1 turnaround school in 2015, it received a grade of D. Based on 2017-2018 results through the state's accountability system, Westlake Junior High's school grade is B. Westlake Junior High School meets the criteria to exit school turnaround. Additionally, I received an email that went along with this that said, the Utah State Board of Education identified Westlake as one of the top 5 in the state that showed the most growth since identification as a turnaround school. This is a remarkable achievement that should make every Mustang extremely proud. Congratulations." Now, this is something that teachers and students, those who are currently here and those who are here just the last couple years, all had a hand in. It's something that we should be extremely proud of, and we'll be looking actually for the proper way to celebrate this moving forward. But for now, I wanted to make sure you had that information, that to know that Westlake has made a remarkable accomplishment in becoming a school with a B letter grade after it was in the category much lower of a D letter grade just a few years ago. I look at that and think, there's no ceiling for what our Mustangs can do, and our next target is the A. Job well done, Mustangs. Thank you very much. Let's turn to Israel to learn more about sign language.
All right, hello Mustangs. We are going to be teaching you a new sign today, but first of all, I would like to say how excited I have been to see all of you signing with Israel. And what we're going to teach you today is two different ways to tell him hello, and we've actually have a couple of students that are gonna help us with that. Now we'd like to show you a couple of ways that are not appropriate to say hi to Israel, and a couple of ways that are appropriate to say hi. All right, so as you saw in our first example, there's a couple of things wrong with that one. The first was she was walking much too fast for Israel to actually see. And when she said hi, she was still too far away for him to be able to visually see that she said hi. With the second one, yes, she was within his vision, but she was very much in his space. Nobody wants to have somebody right in their face like that. The other thing is she grabbed his walker. Because his walker is how he gets around, grabbing his walker or moving it or bumping it is the same as grabbing or moving him. So please never touch his walker unless a teacher specifically gives you permission to. With our next scenario, as you saw, she slowed down and then she leaned over just a little so she was within his vision and waved to him. So that is an appropriate way, especially when you're hurrying to class. And then the last way, she came up behind him, tapped him twice on the shoulder to get his attention, and waited until he made eye contact and said hello. So those are the last two were appropriate ways to say hello, and the first two were not appropriate ways. And I look forward to seeing you guys talk with Izzy this next week. Bye.
Thanks, Israel, so cool. Let's turn to Mr. Howe to learn about another thing every Mustang must know.
Mustangs, this is Mr. Kimball instead of Mr. Howe. What a lucky upgrade. As you know, we've been working on the five things every Mustang must know. By now, you should know what year you will graduate, you should know what college or university you plan to attend, and you should know what your goal RI score is for showing a year and a half's growth to earn a hoodie. This week, we're going to work on knowing our STEM philosophy. This is it. Try, fail, and try again until we succeed. That's it. That's all you've got to memorize to check off the fourth thing every Mustang must know. Once again, try, fail, and try again until we succeed is the fourth thing every Mustang must know.
Thanks, Mr. Kimball. Now we're going to see a quick video on how to check your grades.
It's now time for our weekly whip around.
Oh,
cool. Thanks for sharing.
That's it for us. Thanks for watching.
This is Mustang Media.